morning, everyone. Thanks so much for coming by. I just, for proof, it is 2:04 in the morning, so this is perfect timing, and I hope you got some rest, because it is Tuesday. This is considered my long day. Anyway, come on in. You're the first to come in. I just moved to this place, so come on in. Excuse the mess. Jump over the boxes. Jump over the desk. Whatever you need to do. Okay. I gotta keep my eye on the clock too, because I have to be at work at 3. People always ask me, how do I get my hair so curly, or how does it stay? Well, this is how I walk in the door. So I have a curling iron right here. I'm gonna look at my scripts on my computer. I'm also watching the news. There's my mirror. Hello. Let's do this. Showtime. I go through my scripts, I go through the latest headlines, I try to read every single newspaper so I can see all the headlines. At the same time, you see that desk back there? We have scanners all lined up across the back, and I can pretty much hear them all morning long. So I can hear the dispatcher come across should there be something that happens. And keep in mind, you know, even though it's 3 o'clock and we don't start till 4, if there's breaking news, we're going on the air no matter what. So I always have to be ready, or we always have to be ready in the newsroom, and we're always on alert, even though most folks are still in bed. We're wide awake, keeping track of the stories that are happening at the time. So then the other thing is, I usually take this iPad in there, and this thing has come in handy because I can literally control what's on your screen at home just by moving this. We got this really cool app, because a lot of times we say, send us your tweet and you'll see it on air. You really will. It's called TV Interact. We just click on it right here. If I scroll down, I can see all the local tweets that are happening right about now. What I do is I just pick a few of them. So let's see the Ashton. I'll pick that one. And then as soon as I click live, I have control of what's on your screen. That's something that's kind of cool, a new feature that we rolled out. And that's something that a lot of people don't know about. I've got the power right here. This also has the power to go live too. So at any time. The other thing that people always ask me is, how are you able to juggle everything? Well, the reality is my hands are full. With social media taking the world by storm, I always have my iPad in my hand. If not, I've got my cell phone somewhere around here. And then here's the other thing. We always get jokes on Twitter. People are like, it looks like you're playing with a remote control, or you're playing with something. It's true. This is what controls the teleprompter. So when I, just with the click of a button, am able to scroll up and down. So basically, I read at my own pace, and this is what controls it. The other thing is, I always say, oh, they're talking in my ear, or the producer's talking to me. What I mean is this IFB right here. See, it goes right into my ear. It's molded to my ear, and I can hear everything that's going on from the back just with this little earpiece. The other thing we've got is the microphone, and we do a pretty good job at hiding it. That's the other question people ask me is, where is your microphone? Where's your earpiece? All that kind of stuff. I hide it right here under my dress. Okay, so it adds a few extra inches. It's not necessarily flattering, but it's there. That's really it.
Hey, Rashi, morning. Hey.
So once I get on set, I sit next to Michelle Merhar and Mike Iskovitz. During the entire 4 and 5 o'clock hours, and then at 6 o'clock, it's kind of like the anchor shift change where Jose comes in and sit next to him for the full hour, and then at 7 o'clock, I say my little goodbye. That's gonna do it for us at 6 a.m. The news at 7 starts now, and so then I come out here to the studio. Sometimes I'll sit here and just kind of get a feel for what's happening throughout the rest of the morning, since after all, I've been in there for 3 hours. The other thing is, it's time to have my lunch, right? Because I have my breakfast at 2 o'clock. That's something else people always ask me about is, what's your meal routine like? Well, lunchtime is about 7:07, so I'll have... Okay, so right now, we're about to go to commercial break, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look for tweets, because we need to use them on the air. So, big story today is obviously J.J. Watt. You can work out with them at home. They'll even deliver pizza to your doorstep. So I'm looking for tweets right now. I'm using my cell phone also to make it a little easier, and then of course I got the laptop here. So I'm plugged in 3 different outlets here. So it's just before noon. It's about that time. It's lunchtime, and it's also nap time. A lot of people ask me, well, how do you do it getting up at 2 o'clock in the morning? How are you not so tired all day? And the truth is, I kind of live with naps. Now, it's not a long nap. And especially on Tuesdays, it's a long day, so I have to come back to shoot public service, which is Ola Houston Asia Connection. Those are our community affairs, and we do that at 2 o'clock, so it looks like I have about 2 hours to grab something to eat and lay down for just a couple minutes. And then after that, we have an event to go to, so you're invited to that too. So right now, I'm gonna head home, because I'm starving. All right, we're back after lunch, after a quick nap. I'm feeling good, feeling ready. It's time now to film public service, which is Ola Houston and Asian Connection.
Buenos dias y bienvenidos, everyone. I'm Rita Garcia with Ola Houston. Ventanas de oportunidad, or windows of opportunity.
What are you doing?
Looking through scripts, making sure everything's correct, and making sure I can get all the names right. It's been a long day, okay?
Hi, everyone. I'm Rita Garcia, and this morning on Asian Connection, time to put on those high heels and that fan. So it's Tuesday, like I said, this morning. This is my long day. It is about, let's see, what time is it? Almost 3 o'clock. And so what you see behind me going on is Jose is actually filming Black Voice. These are a public service shows. I just finished wrapping up Ola Houston Asian Connection. These are very nonprofit driven. Some of the guests that we had on today are like Neighborhood Centers, Inc. And it's all about giving back. It's all about sharing issues within the Hispanic community, Asian American community. And that's really what we focus on. They air on Saturdays and Sundays. So that's kind of a little secret. Sometimes people call me and they're like, do you work every single day? Nope. It's TV magic is what I like to call it. It's all pre-recorded this Tuesday, or every Tuesday, I should say. And so that's what we just finished up. We have another event to go to because it's Trey the Truth Day. And so, like I said this morning, I hope you're well rested because it's going to be a long one.
Hey guys, so we are here at Trey Day, and as you can see, I'm hiding in this media tent. Not only am I trying to beat the heat, but the concert is so loud. We understand T.I., T-Pain, Trey the Truth is en route right now, and this is one of the many events that I wanted to stop by and really say hi to some of our viewers, and it really showed as soon as we pulled up.
Kind of self-explanatory. You can look around. It's like it's more of a family thing for me, man. You know, I live and die for this city, man. I'm Houston to the death. And you know, regardless if it's my day or whatever it is, I'm gonna make it a day for the kids and those in need. You know, I'm gonna be the big homie like always. And we're having fun right now, probably gonna rise and rise. And she always represents with me no matter what. So when it comes to 26 and everything else, you know, it's a city family, man. I am Houston.
It's great to be out here.
It means the world to me, man. You know what I'm saying?
You don't want to be on TV?
We really get to do this a lot, so you know what I'm saying? The time we do get off and the time we do have, you know, not scheduled to do anything, of course, I'm going to come out here for Trey. I'm going to come out here for the kids. I'm going to come out here for the city, the state. You know, so it means a lot to me, too.
Well, guys, thank you all so much for coming. It's been such a long day. I mean, we have been from the office to nap time to back to the office, then out to one of those events, so it's about that time where I can finally start taking off all this makeup, finally. And you know what, I do have a confession, I like to cook, but the truth is I'm so tired tonight, I just can't, so I heated up some leftovers. Anyway, what time is it? I think it's 7 o'clock. So anyway, it's bedtime, so thank you all so much for joining me, and remember the hashtag #WakeUpWithRita, okay? We'll see you guys in the morning, bye.